Claire, thank you very much for speaking to us today. First of all, tell us a little bit about yourself and the campaign.
Right, thank you. And I'd like to say, actually, it's lovely to be back in Gibraltar again. And as always, had a really warm welcome when I've been here. And it's clearly the election's in May, so it's starting to hot up a bit now. So, but, you know, as I say, getting a very good response from being here and also in the rest of the southwest, which is the region that is shared with Gibraltar for the European Parliament.
And what has your visit entailed thus far?
So far, I met with the Deputy Governor yesterday afternoon and with the Chief Minister, Fabian Picardo, both of which, obviously, the main focus of the meetings were around what's happening with the border crossing and just the incredible impact that's having on people's lives, going to and from work, meeting with families, and it's inconceivable that for people in the UK who just don't have to worry about this on a daily basis.
You're quite heavily involved with Unite the Union. Have you sort of met with them whilst you've been here?
Absolutely, yes. No, they've been very supportive, very helpful, and I work for Unite myself, so there's a lot of affinity. Above and beyond the very serious issue of the border crossing, we face the same issues with our members in workplaces across the UK.
But primarily you're here, on your quest to become an MEP for Gibraltar.
Absolutely.
Okay. Tell us a little bit about how you sort of came to work with the Labour Party and the Union, considering you've come from such a staunchly Tory background.
I grew up in the 1980s, and I grew up seeing the impact that Margaret Thatcher had on communities across the UK, and I wanted to work with the trade union. I've been a trade unionist, actually. I was a trade unionist before I was a Labour Party member. But I could see that the two things went hand in hand, that if you don't have a political voice for workers that delivers for all of a community, then you can do so much in the workplace, but there is so much more you can do with a political representation as well.
So what's next for you and your campaign trail?
Well, I'm happy that I'm here and will be here until tomorrow, and I very much am looking forward to coming back in the campaign as well. But it is now, obviously, it's huge constituencies in the European Union election, so I will be just going out and about and meeting as many voters as I can, and having the opportunity to build support for Labour, so we have a Labour MEP for the region after the elections in May.
Now, I think it's been quite obvious in some opinion polls recently that Labour is the favourite to get the majority in next year's general election in the UK. How do you believe that a Labour government might deal with the Spain-Gibraltar situation differently?
Well, I think it would be really important to have both working with the GSLP, who are a sister party to the Labour Party, having a Labour MEP and a Labour government to actually bring pressure to bear. And I know I've spoken with colleagues in the Labour Party about just how significant this issue is. And Gareth Thomas, who's the Shadow Europe Minister, the Labour Europe spokesperson at the moment. And I know Gareth is very keen to come out here as well. Those three levels, being able to work together in Westminster, dealing with the Spanish government, but also at Brussels, because I do see this as a European issue, then one hopes we would be working very hard to bring about a resolution to ease the lives of people here and in Berlin.
So how do you think that it might be able to be solved, or at least eased, from a European point of view?
I think the Commission have a vital role to play in this. And again, that's the Labour Party is part of a mainstream grouping in the European Parliament, so which unfortunately the Conservatives aren't. So there is much more influence you can bring to bear in the way that Europe works, the way it works in Brussels, to bring about talks and a successful resolution to this. The Labour government did take an active role in tripartite talks establishing tripartite talks, and it has to be that any solution involves the Gibraltarian people being involved in those discussions as well.
And how do you sort of think that the current government have dealt with the situation in the UK? Is there anything that perhaps the government, a Labour government, would have done differently?
Well, one would like to think a Labour government would have brought about a solution, because there's been a lot of talk, but there's, the day before I arrived, I was talking to people when I got here, you know, there had been two-hour queues at the border again. Talk is fine, but we need outcomes as well.
Do you think that Gibraltarians are fair to sort of be worried about a possible Labour government, in the sense that, the previous situation with Peter Hain and that possible mixing of sovereignty between Spain and England, is that an issue that perhaps they need to worry about at all?
Not while I have breath in my body. as I said before, it is absolutely about Gibraltarians' say in your own, in the future. I do not believe that there is anything at all to worry about having a Labour government in the UK. And I, as I said, I've obviously spoken to Labour politicians about this, you know, Emma Reynolds before, and now Gareth Thomas, and with Ed Miliband when Fabian came over for the Labour Party conference in the autumn last year. Fabian and I met with Ed, and Ed was very clear about his support for Gibraltar as well. So we have it from the top of the party down.